5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, and liftoff, the final liftoff of Atlantis on the shoulders of the space shuttle. America will continue the dream.
If you are a fan of the space program, Ames Research Center was the place to be in Silicon Valley on the morning of July 8th. Ames opened its doors to the public to share the excitement of the launch of the last shuttle mission, STS-135. As crowds watched the high-definition video coverage, local NASA experts, including former NASA Deputy Administrator and Ames Center Director Hans Mark, gave behind-the-scenes commentary on the final preparations. When the orbiter Atlantis lifted off the pad, emotions were close to the surface for many who watched the launch.
I feel just so great that it actually went off without a hitch and that they're up there speeding around the Earth right now.
It's kind of thrilling because you've seen how far America's come since the moon landing and after the last mission, and it's amazing. It was really fun.
When the shuttle finally went off, the whole room exploded. It was fantastic. People love NASA. People love the space shuttle. And they're excited to see what we do next.
Now standing by for external tank separation.
It marked the end of an era for Ames, which not only helped develop the shuttle design, but trained astronauts and flew science experiments throughout the program's 30-year history. But even as Atlantis makes its final journey, Ames is already turning towards the future. In recent years, NASA's new spacecraft, the multipurpose crew vehicle, has been receiving the same cutting-edge support as the shuttle. Scale models have been tested in Ames wind tunnels, and new heat shield formulas have been developed. When it flies, a new page of Ames's history will go with it.